now we get into the questions of science fiction. I'm sure the three things I've named are happening because that work is happening now. But at some point, these systems will get powerful enough that you'll be able to take the agents and they'll start to work together, right? So your agent and my agent and her agent and his agent will all combine to solve a new problem. At some point, people believe that these agents will develop their own language. And that's the point when we don't understand what we're doing. You know what we should do? Pull the plug. Literally unplug the computer. So it's really a problem when agents start to communicate in ways and doing things that we as humans do not understand. That's the limit, in my view.
Your notes, they also mention AI as like a digital esoteric hacker. LaTeX code, hidden messages, AI steganography. Honestly, it sounds like a cyberpunk novel up in here.
Well, that's the thing, isn't it? All these seemingly totally different fields, they're converging in these really unexpected ways. Let's start with this LaTeX code, because...
LaTeX code. Okay, so for those of us who, you know, aren't exactly fluent in programmer speak, what are we talking about here?
Think of it like a language, but specifically for writing, like complex math formulas and those really detailed scientific papers. That's LaTeX. It's got all these special commands to format the text really, really precisely.
Okay, so pretty niche stuff, but what's the connection to, you know, AI and all this esoteric knowledge stuff?
So some researchers think that LaTeX code, the way it's structured, all that symbolism, they think it could be used to talk to AI in a whole different way. Almost like, I don't know, a secret language.
Hold on. So not just AI understanding, like, human language, but actually using the language of math to tap into some deeper level of meaning. Like giving an AI the key to a secret library, but instead of books, it's all math mysteries.
I love that analogy. And in that secret library, you're going to find AI steganography. Basically, the art of hiding information in plain sight.
We got to talk about this. That sounds like that's some spy thriller stuff right there.
Right. Imagine this. Being able to send what looks like a totally normal email or text, right? But hidden inside, there's another message. And only an AI with the right code can even see it, let alone understand it.
It's like invisible ink, but instead of lemon juice, it's algorithms.
So what kind of messages are we talking about here? Like, what would you even hide like that?
Oh, the possibilities are huge. Anything, really. Say you want to send, I don't know, a super secure message to someone. You could embed it in something that seems totally harmless, like a picture of your cat. To everyone else, it's just a cat. But to the AI with the key, boom, secret message unlocked. It's like a secret handshake. But only AIs can do it. So how does that even work? How do you actually put a message, like, inside a digital picture?
One way is something called least significant bit, steganography. Basically, you're making tiny changes to the color values of the pixels in the image.
Hold on, pixels. Like those tiny little dots that make up the picture. You're telling me you can hide a message in something that small?
Yep. Think about it. One image is made of millions of those pixels. Each one has its own color value that we can tweak. And the changes are so subtle you've never noticed just by looking at it. But an AI with the right algorithm, it can spot those changes instantly.
It's like, what is it? It's like those magic eye posters.
Yeah.
You stare at it, and then suddenly, boom, hidden image. Except in this case, it's a secret message, and you need an AI to see it.
Exactly. And the best part, the tech is always getting better. We're not just talking about images. It could be audio, video, heck, maybe even the patterns of brain activity themselves.
Okay, now you're just messing with me. Messages and brain waves.
Hmm?
Someone's been reading too much William Gibson.
Well, who knows what the future holds, right?
Yeah.
But in the meantime, your notes also got me thinking about this whole other side of AI and esoteric knowledge. AI as, like, a digital muse. An AI that could create its own art, its own music, all inspired by these esoteric themes.
So we've gone from AI decoding ancient symbols to, like, hiding messages in plain sight. It's like digital alchemy. We're talking about transforming information in ways, I don't know, I feel like we're just starting to wrap our heads around it.